Welcome to the Great Gnome Caper, 2006. A couple weeks ago, on a Sunday afternoon, I had to go into Hancock to return some newbies. And I had to go to the Family Dollar store next door to pick up some Swiffer mops stuff for Kayla. And when I got in there, a little gnome caught my attention, and I picked it up and I thought, wouldn't it be neat if it somehow wandered its way over to Mike and Carolyn's house and added itself to their other gnome? So when I got home, I shared this idea with Ellen and Jake, and they just thought it was a really cool idea. So in the process, Ellen said...
I said, well, it might get lonely. So maybe we could put one, somewhere else, too. And that was the birth of the gnome caper.
So we're planning on putting these 8 gnomes in various locations throughout Mike and Carolyn's property and not telling them that they're there. But on the bottom of each gnome is a single word that if they get all 8 gnomes, they'll have the entire sentence that they have been visited by the gnome fairy. And eventually we'll show them this video, which hopefully Jake will pimp out with his new camera. And we can all have a good laugh at it.
Crazy Wacky Animal Adventures. Alright, yeah. On this episode of Crazy Wacky Animal Adventures, we're going to go see the elusive gnome. See, these people happen to have a very large gnome infestation, so we're going to go... Oh, there's one of the little buggers now. Hold on, let me see if you can... I don't know if you can see this, folks, but... God, look at him! Oh, God, he's the ugliest thing I've ever seen! Watch out for those beady little eyes. He'll kill ya. Trying as close as I can, folks. I don't know. I'm putting life and limb here. Life. I don't know if anyone's ever gotten this close to a gnome before. They're quite, quite deadly. His eyes are following me. Hold on. Let me see. Oh. Alright, he's got my hand. He's... Oh my God. Oh God, he's gone! God, that hurt. Crazy Wacky Animal Adventures. Alright, here we are at take 2 of Crazy Wacky Animal Adventures. And, well, my leg got better after numerous treatments of being eaten by boars. But you know, whatever modern medicine thinks. Okay, now, here we go. We're going again to see the gnomes. Apparently that show got higher ratings than my bunny episode. That's not the point. This time, we're going out to the woodland gnome. These are slightly more elusive creatures and less prone to try and kill the person filming. Get it? Kill the person filming. Whatever. Okay. There we go. There's one. Oh, look at him. Oh, he's beautiful. In his natural habitat. Oh, look. He's even got a little bunny with him. Rat bastard. Trying to steal my goddamn idea. Alright. Let's see how close I can get to him. Alright. Here we go. He's still getting spotted me yet. Alright. Let's see. Let me try and reach out. It's alright, little gnome. Oh God! Fucking shit, not again! Oh God! Do-do-do-do. Beautiful four spacious skies of amber waves of grain. Do 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 do. I'm so lonely, oh so lonely. I'm so lonely and shadowy alone. No one loves me, and it's kind of silly, but not really. Cause it's filling my body with rage. I'm the smartest, most intelligent, most physically fit. If only everyone would realize it. Maybe if I change the world, they'll see. Oh, never mind. I'm good. That's.
You can edit.
You're pretty cute, you know.
A little less conversation, a little more action. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me. A little more bite, a little less spark. A little less fight, a little more spark. Close your mouth and open up your heart and maybe satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby. Baby, close your eyes and listen to the music. Dig to the summer breeze. It's a groovy night and I can show you how to use it. To come along with me and put your mind at ease. Hey! A little less conversation, a little more action. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction. A little more bite, a little less bark. A little less fight, a little more spark. Shut your mouth and open up your heart and baby, satisfy me.